Hello, welcome to this new tutorial. In this one, we're gonna make a quiz game in Windows Form. So as you can see, this is the layout of the game at the moment. I'm just gonna go over the preview. So if I click on start, we debug the game. So at the moment, it changes the questions. So right now, he asks what's the color of the sky. We can click on any of these buttons, and it will take you to the next question. So if I click on blue, it takes me to the next question. Next question is what's the main character from Iron Man? We can click on any one of them, so I can just click on Peter Quill for now. What's the what game publisher made the game above? So that's the image of Fortnite. It's obviously made by Epic Games, so we can just click on, let's say, Epic Games for now. Capital city of England is London. Say this one is like Call of Duty or something, just for now. What's the main character of this game? So just answer it wrong. And in this one, obviously, Counter-Strike CSGO. Who is Gerald looking for? So let's just say Gerald is looking for donuts instead of Siri in this case. So right at the end, it gives us the percentage, sorry, the final result of it. So it says quiz ended. You have answered four questions correctly. The total percentage is 50%. And then we can click OK to play again. So when you click OK, it resets back to the start of the quiz. So we're going to make this project from start to finish in Visual Studio. So just go ahead and make a new project. So I've used, excuse me, I've used some of these temporary projects before. So just click on, I'm using the Visual Studio 2019 at the moment. You can use any to follow along with this tutorial. So let's click on new project. So at the moment, I need to find the Windows Forms from the list. So if I go and make sure that you use the Windows Forms from with the .NET framework. So that's the one that's used to create a desktop application, and that gives you the designer view as well. So if you use the .NET Core framework, then you won't have the designer with it. Okay, so if you double click on that or just click next on that one. So let's just say quiz game in Windows Form, VS. For now, because I already have one that's similarly named, so just gonna add the VS at the bottom of it. So click on OK, click on, sorry, click on Create. One thing to mention here is that if you just make sure you know where your project is being saved. So at the moment, it's being saved inside my Documents, Visual Studio, and then inside the Projects folder. So I like to keep the projects tidy, so I know where to find them when I need them. So just click on Create. That should create the blank project. So I'm just going to move this one away from here. Okay. So this is the blank project for now. So just resize this and start adding our components to it. So we're going to need one picture box to show the main pictures of it. Let's just drag and drop a picture box here. So make it slightly bigger. We're gonna need a label, so I can drop the label here. So just gonna change a few things to this one. So first of all, let's change it to LBL question in the name, so we can call this to identify the questions inside of the C sharp script. I'm gonna change the auto size to false, so we can set how big or small the label should be on the screen. Let's just make it slightly wider. Okay, so if you come back to the bottom here, you'll see the text. So just type in question here, text align. Let's set that to middle, padded so it looks nice and tidy. I'm going to change the font size of it to make it slightly bigger, so 14 and bold. So, okay. All right, so now we're going to need four buttons. So let's drag and drop the button here. Two and four. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just set the size of one button first, and then I'll copy and paste that size to the other ones. So let's say this is the standard size for the button. So if I just go to the properties, find the size from there. Then I can set the size of these as well. Okay, so that's done. Maybe bring them a little bit closer together. So this is would be the layout for the app at the moment. So we need to import the images to this app. So at the moment, what I've done is I've got I've got a couple of pictures saved already. So I've got a picture of CSGO, Fortnite, Gears of War, Halo, and another generic one for just for the questions, and a Witcher 3 picture that I've saved from Google. So this one here is going to be used for questions that don't necessarily need any images. You can still add it to it, but obviously if you want to have a question just for the question's sake, then you can just use this one. So let's import the pictures in. So if you right click on the picture box, click and choose image, click on import, and then we can just highlight all of them and open it, click on open. Now if you choose the questions picture from there. So now it's a bit out of size, so we just need to make it. So change, click on the little triangle button over there, and then you can click on size mode and change it to stretch image. So that way it fits in nicely with the questions picture box. Right. Another thing we need to do is we need to identify the tags for the button. So if you click on each button there, and then we can go in and change the tag of it. So this first one, I'm just going to type in 1, press enter. Second one, type in 2, press enter again. Type in 3, press enter, tag, type in 4. So the tags are going to help us identify which is the right answer for the questions that we are going to ask in this app. So I'm just going to hold on the shift button and then click on the buttons here, so that way I select all of them, right? So not the form, but just the buttons. So if I hold shift and select all four of them, and I need to click on the little lightning bolt icon here, that's for the events. So I'm going to change, I'm going to add an event to the click part of the event here. So say say check answer event, and then hit enter. So this would add a event. So right now, anytime any of these buttons are clicked, this event here is going to trigger. Okay, so we also need a function for this. So I'm just going to zoom in a little bit so you can see better. So we're going to make a custom function. So say, last question like this. So this function is going to run every time we want the app to ask a new question. So I'm just going to put in an int qnum inside of this one. So the qnum, it basically is a question number. So what we're going to do is we're going to have lots of different questions inside of this function, and then each time this number changes, it's going to ask a different question. So let's just go and set up the variables for this up first. So right at the top here, let's say, so the line I've just added now is a comment. So if you put in a slash slash in front and then it turns green, so you can simply put any sort of information there and it helps keep the code organized. So we're going to need a few integers. So int first of all is correct question. Okay. Question number, let's just set that one to 1. And then we have int score, int percentage, then int total questions. So okay, so each of these we need in order for this game to work, and then I'll show you how these are implemented as we go through it. Okay, so let's go and set up the questions first, and then we can come back to the event. Okay, so the questions are going to be organized through what's called a switch statement. So a switch statement allows us to sort of check for numbers and then compare those numbers with the condition, and then we can do anything once that condition is met. So if we go to switch here and then declare a switch statement and then put the qnum inside of this first. Okay, so inside of here we can declare various different cases. So in this first one is going to be case one. You do a colon next to it. And then obviously we have to declare what we're going to do. So let's say picture box one, which is this picture box here. We have to tell you what picture we want to use for this. So let's go click on image. Now we're going to say properties.resources.questions. So that's the properties and resources folder that you can see inside your Solutions Explorer. So when we imported those pictures, it copied it from the downloads folder that I have here inside the project. So right now we have access to these inside of it. Okay, so each cases, they have a break. So once this condition is met, we need to tell it when to stop. So if this number is one, it's going to come here and find one, and then it's going to do whatever we have asked it to do in here, and then it's going to break from there. So let's go and add a question. So that'll be on question.text. So that's the label. And now we can say here, color of the sky, and then semicolon. So now in the first question, that's it's going to change the label to this question here. And we also need to change the button one.text to some blue. To yellow. Say orange. Last one is going to be button 4.text is equals to, let's say, red. Okay, so these are the so whenever the first question is asked, it's going to change the question label to these, and then it's going to go find each of these buttons and change their values to them as well. We have added a correct question integer here. That's going to become useful. In this case, is we're going to need to say which of these four are the correct answer. So correct answer is nope. Okay, I put that as correct question. It should be correct answer. Yeah. Okay, so let's say correct answer is equals to one. So it's the first one. That's the correct answer in this case, literally. Right, so we're gonna need to do a few more questions. So obviously, because the bodies are going to be very similar to each other, so we can copy and paste them and then change it accordingly. So we can copy it from case to break, then paste it here. So in this one, we're going to look for case two. Okay, so case two can also have the same question picture. So okay. So what is the name of the main character from Iron Man? Oh, in this one we can say Tony Stark. Rhodey. Peter Quill. Right, so in this one, obviously the correct answer is number two, so we're going to change that one to number two. Okay, so let's go and ask another question. So this is question number three. Okay, so so now we can access all of them. So if you delete that part until the resource and just put a full stop next to it, you can see all the resources that we have inside of this. So let's ask the CSGO question first. So we can access the CSGO image here. Okay, so you can say what's the name of this game. Right, so let's say Battlefield, Fortnite, or CSGO. Alright, so now the answer is, the correct answer is number 4. So we're going to change that one to number 4. Okay. Let's go and change to question number 4. Same thing again. So let's go find the Fortnite image here. Is which publisher made this game? Activision, Epic Games. Square Enix. So the right answer to this question is number 3. Let's change that one to number 3. Okay, so we're up to question 4. Let's go and make question 5. So again, let's go and change that to Gears of 4. Assassin's Creed. Uncharted. Oh, let's go to the capital here. Or we can simply say Call of Duty. Okay. So the answer is obviously number 1. So we can move on to the next one now. So let's go and make that number 6. After Gears of 4, it's Halo. So we'll make obviously it's number 3, so let's change that one, correct answer to number 3. I'm going to go and make question number 7. Okay, the question is who was Geralt looking for in Witcher 3. Okay, so let's say first one is Victoria, second one Mr. Donut, Ciri or Yennefer. Okay, so obviously number 3 is the correct answer in this one. Let's add one more question, then we can move on to the event. So this one's going to be a text-based question again, so we don't have to add another picture to it. So let's just say, so the correct answer is number 4. Let's go and add that. So now we have 8 questions with the pictures, the main question, and all 4 answers to it. So let's just see how this actually would work. So what we want to do, we want to dynamically load up the question and the answers to the buttons. And then once that happens, then the person who's playing should be able to click on any one of them to move on to the next one. So let's go and see what we can do here. So I want to do first, I want to just make sure that we understand how to make this work. So right now, if I go here and add ask question function here, so it's going to give us a red line here because we need to pass in a value because we're looking for an integer to be passed through this function, right? So we need to modify something. So if I say, for example, 1, right, so that should still work because it's looking for a number. So if I start the game now, okay, it kind of just loads up the first question, but we can't really do anything at the moment because none of the events been put in just yet. And if I click, if I put in, say, number 6 here, then it loads up the image and the question and the answers as well. So you can see what's the main character's name in the game above. So you got Drake, Lara Croft, Master Chief, or Marcus. Okay. So the idea behind it is we are going to increment this. We're going to pass in this value inside of this function. So whenever we go into here, we can increment it dynamically, and then that would change the questions on the Windows form. So if we go here and then change question number to that, so right now it's got 1, so it should load up the first question for us. So it loads up the first question, but if we change that to number 2 and load it, and then it's going to change to the second question because it's going through and finding the number and then it's adding to it. Okay. So what we're going to do here as well is we're going to put in the total questions is equals to 8. So that's the how many questions we have for this game. Okay. So what we want to do now is we're going to need to identify which buttons were clicked, and then to identify whether the right answers were clicked on there. Okay, so one of the ways to do that is with each event, it has a object sender and then an event argument with it. So what we're interested in is the sender. So check which object sent this event. Let's make a variable here called sender object. So these are what's called local variables. So let's take a look. A sender object has to be a button. Then so we're linking to the sender from here, so we'll identify the sender, and once we have identified it, we can check its tags. So let's say here so button tag is equals to, so now the button tags are generally strings, so they are text, but we need to convert it to a number in order to compare it with the correct answer integer. So let's convert that into 32. So we're running the convert function, and then we're running the convert class from there, and then we're checking for the int convert to int 32. So it's going to take the string from the sender object, which is going to be one of our buttons, and then we can access the tag from here. Okay, so what it's going to do is it's going to convert that to an int, and it's going to save it inside this button tag. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to check if, let's say, button tag is equals to correct answer. Okay, so if these two values are exactly accurate, exactly the same as each other, then we can say, for example, here question number plus plus, and then say ask question, and then we're going to pass in the question number. So what we're going to do is we're going to find out whether they are first exactly accurate, and then once we find that out, then we're going to add 1 to the question number. So right now it's 1, and then once if the button that we clicked is exactly the same as each other, then we're going to add 1 to it, and then right after that we're going to run this function with that value inside of it. So if you run this now, so if I click on any other buttons, nothing's going to happen, right? But if I click on blue, it should change over to the next question. So once again, if I click on Tony Stark, Rhodey, or Peter Quill, nothing's going to happen here. But if I click on Tony Stark, and then it moves to the next question. So same as here. So this is a good way to check whether the program knows between the right answers and the wrong answers. Click on Epic Games. Okay, nothing happens. Okay, that's good. So Drake, Lara Croft, Marcus now. Okay. Mr. Donut. I'll be looking for Mr. Donut, but okay. CV. Capital. Okay. Birmingham, Liverpool, Brighton, London. Okay, so since it's the last question, because we already have reached the top part of this. So because we have reached number 8 there, there is no other number or the condition for the program to do. So that's why when we get to the last one, it doesn't do anything. Okay, it's a good thing we know how to change that. So we're going to move that down here because we don't want to move the questions as the people are answering the right question. We want to move it even when they have answered it wrong, we can move it to the next question then. So what we're going to do is if the question answered is correct, we're going to add 1 to the score. Okay. Because it's outside of the condition right now, even if we answer the question wrong, it will still move to the next one. So if we run it again, so right now if I say orange, it will still move to the next one, but only thing is it won't add anything to the score. Okay, because we need to find out how to check for how many questions that user got right and how many questions they got wrong. Okay, so now we are going to add the final bit of the game where we check. So if we get to the question number, so if your question number is equals total questions. Right, so the number of questions is equals to the total number of questions that's available in this app. Then we're going to have to work at the percentage first. Let's work at the percentage first, and then, so let's say percentage equals to, so we're going to need another int because this is an integer, so we're going to need to convert everything that we do into an integer first. So let's go to math.round, so we need to round down the number or round up the number. Okay, so instead of here we need to say double, so we're going to then do another bracket for, let's say score multiplied by 100 and then divided by the total questions. Okay, so let me just explain what we're doing here. So obviously because the percentage here is declared as an integer, we can't hold anything other than an integer inside of it. So percentages a lot of times go inside the decimal points. So we do need to calculate it, and then once we have calculated it, we need to store it back into the percentage. So So that's why we're using the int and math round. So if we say, for example, get a percentage of 25.5, it's going to round it up or down to exactly 25. Or if you get it to 25.6, it's going to round it to 26. Right, so that's why we're using the doubles. So it kind of helps us accurately calculate what the percentage of the right and wrong answers are. So we're going to times the score by 100 and then divide it by the total number of questions. So at the moment, if we had, like, let's say 10 questions, that's the total, and then the score was 2, then that's times by 100 and then divide that. So that way it would come up to a 20%. Okay, so now let's go and show the message. Messagebox.show. So this is going to have to be a multi-line. So it's still got the semicolon there, and then just make sure everything that we do is inside the brackets here. Okay, so first line is going to be, we do the quotation marks. So quiz ended. And then we'll do a plus new line. So the environment and new line, environment.newline, what it does is it's going to add a new line to it. Otherwise, it's going to, everything's going to be set into one line. So we're using a plus, so we need to join those together. So that's why we're using the plus and then the plus again. So that plus basically means the program is anticipating something else to happen here. So we can say here, you have answered do a space and then do a quotation mark, do a plus here. So you have answered this many questions, right? Questions correctly. Okay. And then we do a plus environment.newline again. Okay. And now that we need to do the show the percentage of it, so your total percentage is, do a space, plus percentage, plus, and then obviously we do need to use the percentage sign here, and then of course we say environment.newline plus. Now we're gonna say click OK to play again. Spaces there. All right, so inside the message box we're showing first the quiz has ended line plus the new line. So basically it's going to be quiz has ended and it's going to go under, then it's going to say you have answered this many questions correctly. That's going to be, and then that's going to start a new line here. Your total percentage is this much, and then that's going to start a new line here, and then the last line is going to read click OK to play again. So once you click OK, so the program is going to stop here until the user clicks OK. Excuse me. So once the click has happened, then we're going to go back here and say score equals to 0. We're going to say question number equals to 0 again, and then question number. Alright. So because once this click event does happen, right, it's going to straight away go in and add another one. So we can set that to a 0 for now, and then it's going to be changed to a number 1. So let me just show you how this let's just try this out and see how it works. Okay, so for now what we want to do is we want to answer all the questions correctly to see how it runs. So let's click in blue. So it's Tony Stark, CSGO, the publisher, Epic Games, Gears of War, Master Chief, Siri, and then London. So I've answered all the questions correctly. So it goes and shows me that you have answered 8 questions correctly. Your total percentage is 100%. And then we're going to click OK to play again. So if I click OK, it goes back to last one. Okay. So if I go and say yellow, then I'm gonna choose this one. Barfield. Okay. And four, it answers four questions right. So, yeah. So right now I answered four questions right and four incorrectly. So it says four questions were answered correctly, and then my percentage is exactly at 50%. And then you can click OK to play again. Okay, so that's that up here. Well, I just need to do one last thing. I haven't added a title to this form. Okay, it just says form one. Okay, so right now let's just go over the code again. So we made, these are the game variables here. So we got the correct answer, question number, score, percentage, and total questions. In the beginning, we made a custom function here for the ask question that takes one argument, which is an integer. So this integer, depending on what the value of this integer is, we show the questions onto the screen. So you got case one. So if this integer is one, we show the first question here. So the first question just uses a simple image, and it has got, this is the question for what's the color of the sky, and these are the answers in each of the buttons. And then so we move on to question two. But it's important to remember the break part. So if you do have a case, you also need to write in a break. So that's where the program is going to know if this condition is met, where to stop when it's met. Okay, after that we move on to question number two, and then obviously from question number three on we use some of the images that we have imported in. Okay, so each of the question comes with another query inside of it, which is the correct answer. So we need to tell the app which of these is the correct answer. Right, so this one is very important because we compare it with the button tag inside of the events. Okay, so each of these questions are got the picture box, label, question, answers in the buttons, and then the correct answer integer right here. Okay, so we got eight questions all totally. So in the beginning of it, inside of this form constructor, this part here we need because that's what's allowing us to use all the buttons and images and labels on the form. That's the custom function that we created. We're passing in the question number variable inside of this function. We're telling it how many total questions that we have. So you can add your own questions to this app, but just make sure that you increase that to however many questions that you have, so that way you can get a right percentage calculation. All right. So this is the check answer event. So this event is linked to each of these buttons. We also added a tag to these buttons here to say which one is number one, two, three, and four, and each of them are linked to this event here. Okay, so in the beginning of the event, we're creating a local variable called sender object, so which is being linked to the sender right here. So then we create a local variable again called button tag. In this one, we're converting the sender object tag to a integer and saving inside of it. Then we have a if statement that's checking if the button tag and the correct answer is exactly the same. If it is, we add one to the score, right? And then the second if statement is checking if the question number and the total questions is exactly the same. So if we have reached question number eight exactly, then we go and calculate the percentage first. So in this one is the formula for calculating the percentage. We got the int, which is a percentage data type. We're doing the math round. We are converting this double back into an int. So we multiply the score by 100 and divide that by the number of questions that we have. Lastly, we show the final message, and then we wait for the user to click OK. And then once the user clicks OK, we set the score back to zero, question number to zero, and then run the ask question function from there. Okay. Hopefully this tutorial was helpful. I'll see you on the next one.